We had two meetings yesterday. There was a breakfast meeting with the Deputy Secretary of State, Mr. Tony Blinken, and the U.S. Special Envoy on Climate Change, Mr. Todd Stern, on climate change. And Prime Minister Anthony spoke on behalf of the Caribbean countries, on behalf of CARICOM, on the issues that we see as being important to us entering the negotiations that will hopefully lead to a legally binding climate change agreement in Paris this year. He identified issues like climate finance, adaptation to climate change, questions of loss and damage. He also spoke of some of the things that we have been experiencing in St. Lucia. So, for example, he said that we have been in a constant cycle of repair and recovery. He highlighted the fact that in 2010 we had the worst drought that we've had in a long time, and then we had Hurricane Thomas that same year. We had not fully recovered from Hurricane Thomas, and then we had the Christmas Eve trough to deal with in 2013, and a drought last year, and the signs this year looking like we may have another very serious water emergency situation on our hands. So all of that to highlight the fact that we really needed greater support, particularly in the area of climate finance and mobilizing that finance and providing access to that finance. The second part of the meeting was with Vice President Joe Biden on what is the Caribbean Energy Security Initiative, and really looking to get greater energy security for the Caribbean. We all spoke to the fact that we are doing a lot of work in renewable energy, trying to transition our economies away from dependence on fossil fuels to renewable energy. We spoke of the need for, again, concessionary finance to help us in that regard. Also support for research and development, because there are countries like St. Lucia, Dominica, Grenada that have access to geothermal, which would give them a basis for developing some baseload power that can replace diesel. But if you're a country like Antigua and Barbuda, or let's say Barbados, that does not have access to geothermal, then the only renewables that are really at your disposal are solar and wind. But these are intermittent sources. You can't base a full transition on intermittent sources. So you now need to put in place storage. And so we ask for access to that research and also for support for storage.